The yeas are 289, and the nays are 137. The bill is passed.
Responding swiftly to the Paris terror attacks, the House passed a bill to keep all Syrian and Iraqi refugees out of the U.S., at least for now. The bill requires top national security officials to personally certify that each refugee from Syria or Iraq is not a threat. That's in addition to the current screening process, which takes up to 2 years.
We will not welcome terrorists.
Three quarters of them are women and children. A quarter of them are over 60 years of age. Refugees are not the enemy.
Don't you think that common sense dictates that we should take a pause and get this right?
More than 2,000 Syrian refugees already live in the U.S., but now more than 30 governors say they won't accept more. The White House has vowed the president will veto the House bill if it reaches his desk, but there are enough votes to override a veto. That's because the president's own party is divided about the refugee issue. 47 Democrats voted for the bill, but the bill faces a tougher road in the Senate where many Democrats oppose it. The Paris attacks have also reopened the debate over anti-terror surveillance versus personal privacy. Some Republicans, including presidential candidate Senator Marco Rubio, are pushing to extend and revise the National Security Agency's phone data collection program. But another candidate, Senator Rand Paul, opposes keeping the program going. And the technology industry is also against another possible anti-terror measure, giving the government a so-called backdoor that would let it break the encryption that keeps online messages hidden. Terrorists have used encryption to communicate privately, but it's also used to protect personal information, business activities, and so on. So the debate over privacy versus security is far from over, and the next terrorist attack may make it more intense than ever. Dale Hurd, CBN News.